What you are in love with, what seizes your imagination, will affect everything.
Only by being a man or woman for others does one become fully human.
To be just, it is not enough to refrain from injustice.
You are called to care for creation, not only as responsible citizens, but also as followers of Christ.
What is the essence of life? To serve others and do good.
For me, why the Jesuit experience is so meaningful is because when we go to these service sites, when we go to these projects, we can apply some of the skills that we've learned through Jesuit. We can apply our problem solving, we can apply our reasoning, we can apply our communication and team building skills, and we can use those different aspects of schooling to really create a positive influence in the environment.
We cannot wait to deal with the structural causes of poverty.
In order to heal our society from an illness that can only lead to new crises,
one must go further and refuse to play its game, substituting love for self-interest as the driving force of society.
Caring for our neighbor, for those who are poor,
who suffer in body and in soul,
for those who are in need,
this is the touchstone.
Being a part of Texas Wins, it's interesting to see how many of these people don't get visitors half the time. When we get there, most of the elderly that we are serving get very excited, like just to see a new face or to see someone else. We fed off their energy and it was by far one of the best concerts we've had. And to me, like, that just shows what the power of music is. That really affected me because, like, that shows how important music can be in someone's life, even if we don't think about it. It's something that we've had since we were very young and we'll have till we're very old, and it can bring back some of the best times of our lives.
Love everyone as if they have the same human dignity as anyone else. Regardless of how much money you have or whatever, it's always good to know that everyone has the same human dignity. And the only way we can truly achieve that is to be committed to justice and loving of everyone.
Nothing is more practical than finding God.
That is, than falling in love in a quite absolute way.
Today, our objective must be to form men and women for others. Men and women who will not live for themselves, but for God and His Christ. For He who lived and died for all the world.
Men and women who cannot even conceive of love of God.
Which does not include love for the least of their neighbors.
Men and women completely unconvinced that love of God, which does not issue injustice for others, is a farce.
It's something I'm very proud of the Jesuit community. During those tough times of the tornado. And I remember the first day after the tornado happened, I couldn't even get to this school because of the disaster that had happened. All the roads were blocked, it was very trafficy. But that suffering was just a microcosm of all the suffering that was going on throughout Dallas. We contacted city leaders and different people that could help point us to impact zones. And that's what we did. We organized a good number of the student body and went to various neighborhoods and schools to help that day. But this was a call to action. It was one that we were not expecting. And it was one that I think Jesuit was uniquely prepared for. And I'm very, very grateful that the student body stepped up and really showcased that others-focused mentality in those tough days. And it's something to reflect on, be proud of, and keep in mind when future tragedies strike that affect our community and our larger communities all around Dallas.
To be loving and committed to justice means to be willing to sacrifice yourself, sacrifice your time, your energy, your things, and to be willing to step in someone else's shoes, to step into their perspective, to really be with them and have genuine interaction with them. To be loving is to truly experience another person.
What are you in love with?
What seizes your imagination
will affect everything.
It will decide what gets you out of bed in the mornings,
what you do with your evenings,
how you spend your weekends,
what you read,
who you know,
what breaks your heart,
and what amazes you with joy and gratitude.
Fall in love.
Stay in love.
And it will decide everything.